Hi, Jane here. As you may have heard, ETFO has a multi-year strategy to address workplace violence in schools. This time around, we're focusing on how the risks of violence are controlled in schools. As an ETFO member, it's important for me to know that school boards are legally required to assess the risks of workplace violence under the Occupational Health and Safety Act. A risk assessment could focus on the school building and grounds, students with high-risk behaviors, working in an isolated area of the school, or dealing with domestic violence concerns in the workplace. Our school boards must also review the risks of violence as often as necessary to continue protecting staff, particularly when things change. For instance, when a student with a history of violence transfers to a new school or classroom, if a new wing is added to the building, when a violent incident was not prevented or controlled, or when an upcoming event introduces new risk factors. It's important that affected staff are consulted as part of the risk assessment, and for all of us to know that it's the school board's legal responsibility to put measures and procedures in place to control identified risks. One way is through the development and use of a safety plan, which includes information like a description of unsafe behaviors, roles and responsibilities, preventative strategies, a crisis response plan, and how to get immediate assistance. Remember, our school boards and principals have a duty to provide educators with as much information about a person with a history of violence as is reasonably necessary to protect us from physical injury. That is, if you can be expected to encounter them, for example, in the classroom, on duty, in assemblies or hallways. That's also true for occasional and itinerant staff and teacher candidates. I should add that this information needs to be shared as soon as possible before you may encounter that person. If you're concerned about the development or use of a risk assessment or safety plan, report your concerns to your principal. You can also speak to your steward if your concerns aren't addressed, or contact your local or PRS. It comes down to this: assessments of the risks of violence, safety plans, and your right to know about a person with a history of violence. We shouldn't settle for anything less. Learn more through ETFO.